Hello everyone and welcome to a studio episode, and today we're reviewing a product that we recently discovered called Robin Buff. Now this stuff's been around for a while. It is a wax color coating kind of material. I'm not really sure how it works. It's a metallic finish. It works really well. Looks really metallic-y when it's done. You are going to need some kind of dry brushes. These little sponge brushes here. They're like dry brushes, I guess. It's like a sponge brush. It's almost like something you'd use for like kid painting. You get a bunch of different sizes. You can get them in an arts and crafts store. Occasionally you can find them in places like Walmart, stuff like that in their arts and crafts section. You can also use big old Q-tips like this one here, and you can use a little tiny brush like this here if you're using that to buff or polish or get into the little tiny cracks. So anyway, the end product kind of looks something like this, as you can see here with Batgirl. And this was done with the silver, and I think it looks pretty good. Looks like a nice little statuette you know, maybe put up next to your TV or something, or next to your comic books. Really cool. She was primed in black, and then I simply laid over a coat of the Robin Buff. So this is what the end result looks like with that. We also did some testing with the antique, or sorry, the, I think this is called Gold Leaf, or... this is Gold Leaf, I believe. And you can see it looks a little bit different, obviously. It's a little brassier. I kind of like this. It kind of reminded me of like tarnished gold or tarnished metal, like tarnished brass. So I'm going to demonstrate, show you guys exactly how this works and how you can kind of do it to your own stuff. You don't have to do it to the entire model. You could do it to a piece of armor if you really wanted to. You could do it to a sword. You could do it to the, you know, metal bits. Just take all the metal bits and just do them with this stuff. It's a great application tool for any of that stuff. But if you're looking to make statuettes look like they're made of metal, and you really want to kind of fool people with it, I mean, once they go pick it up, they're going to realize it's not made of metal. But at a distance on a shelf, they're going to look awesome. So... anyway, what you're going to need to do is apply a very small amount of the Robin Buff on the edge of one of your spongy brushes. And the size doesn't really matter too much unless you want to change the coverage to, you know, a smaller coverage zone. Then obviously go to a smaller sponge or go to a larger sponge. I'm using about a medium-sized sponge here. And we're going to start this demonstration with Kratos. And I have another character I nicknamed Cleocatra. And she's going to be put in gold. And a little bit of her is kind of off camera, so I do speed through that a little bit because she's so tall that it's difficult to get her in frame. Now we start with Kratos. Again, you can start in any direction you want. The direction you go in is going to have a direct reflect on kind of like the lines that appear, which sort of make it look like brushed metals or, you know, older metals that maybe have seen some damage, like they got some scratches on them. The overall effect, though, looks really sharp. And as you see, you just simply dab this on. A very small amount will go a long way. And if you're familiar with dry brushing at all, this is very similar to a dry brushing. You don't really want to saturate everything. You want to leave the shadows in there to kind of give you some depth. You want to make sure that you catch the details that you want to catch. Pop your highlights out, you know, make sure that the tops are brighter than the bottom, sort of thing. Or do it however you want. I mean, the Batgirl one, the example that I showed at first, she was actually done almost completely because I went really heavy on it just to kind of see what would happen. And honestly, it just makes it look like they're little metal statues. This way, it kind of looks like they're metal statues, but it gives it kind of like this antique look almost, where it looks like he's kind of been aged a bit. And I really do like it. I do like the end results. Very metallic-y. It does set on the model. You can remove it with some mineral spirits if you get it on too heavy or you don't like it in spots. You can remove it with mineral spirits. You can also buff it to a nice little shine if you want to buff it. I'll demonstrate that on Kratos' head a little bit in a little while here as we continue going through this process. Now, when you do this, I recommend wearing a mask. It's got a bit of a smell, If you're like me, you know, these smells don't bother you too much, but definitely don't want to be inhaling all these fumes. You may even want to wear gloves because if you get this stuff on your fingers, you're going to have to use mineral spirits and alcohol to get it off. It's very difficult to get off of your fingers if you do get it onto your fingers. But I mean, I always instantly just go wash my hands when I'm done with a project like this anyway. So I did not actually think to put some gloves on in this particular instance. And I'm sure some of you are going to tell me off for not wearing gloves. But I swear to you, I did put a mask on because the smell was a little nasty, especially when you get a little closer to it and when you start using it a little bit more for a good 30, 40 minutes in a hot studio that does not have air conditioning. Eventually, that smell, you're like, ooh, that's, you know, it's definitely got a distinct smell. Probably got to do with some of the materials that are in it and the wax, but there's some other smell there that definitely I don't like. As you can see here, when we go over the different areas of Kratos on this bust piece, I'm trying to catch some of the lines so you can see more detail, and I'm trying to be sporadic about it because I think this is kind of one of those things where you really can't be too specific, and you know, you gotta kind of like go at it and be a little sporadic to make it look, you know, especially if you're going for an antique look like I'm trying to go with with this particular one. You just kind of want to make it look like it's aged. And that's going to be random based on, you know, all different factors. I didn't want to do things like rust or anything like that. Although there is a rust color kind of metallic that they do make for them. But there's actually quite a few other colors. There's white, which I'm not really sure what that looks like. There's a red, a black, all different types of variations on gold and silver. And there's even like a, it's almost like a mahogany color one, like a reddish brown. And that one to me, if you do it really well, you can actually make, it looks more like wood carving when you're done. And actually, I want to kind of demonstrate that too. I'm going to grab some more of it and do some more testing. We got a sample kit, and I was able to test a few of these different colors, and it's neat stuff. It's very cool. If you're not a, you know, even if you're a good painter or you're not a great painter, and you do 3D printing and you got a table full of gray stuff that's just begging to be finished, this is a great way to finish it. And now you have, you know, a bunch of different, you'll have a bunch of different colors there as options that you can use, and you can finish up a bunch of these pieces. I think it's a great thing. It's a really nice effect. The finished pieces look really beautiful, and you really get this like kind of brushed metal, you know, antique kind of look. And again, you can go deeper, you can go thicker, you can add multiple coats, you can try to cover over all the black primer that you put on or whatever. And you can try to get that, you know, coverage a little bit deeper. I didn't want that with some of these pieces. So, you know, it varies. You can use it however you want. I think there's a lot of good use there. And like I said, you don't have to necessarily use it on the whole model. You could use it on a shoulder pad. You could use it on a shield. You know, I've said some of these things, but again, just repeating some of the obvious stuff because a lot of people are going to look at this and go, "I want to paint my whole model silver." Okay, fine, don't. Do you know, use it for part of it. It's a great metallic resource. In my experience, it was about 24 hours and everything else was handleable. You can also paint over it, which I thought was interesting. I had a couple of instances where I actually had like found a bit of primer that I missed afterwards, and I just kind of dabbed some paint in there and got a little bit on the edges and was able to kind of fix it. So yeah, there's the finished Kratos, looking pretty cool. I really like the way this one came out. Now we're going to go ahead and speed up through the Cleocatra, or the Egyptian cat girl, I guess, whatever you want to call her. She's very tall, like I said, so she kind of appears off camera. For this one, we're going to use the gold leaf. Sorry, yeah, that is the gold leaf. Okay, so the one I was actually showing you before was actually not the gold leaf. That was just the antique gold, or gold, I think itself. You'll see the difference between these two. This one is a bit brighter. It's got a bit more warm tone to it. It's less brassy. And I'm going to try and apply this really thick in some areas and kind of fade it in other areas. I want this statuette to look like it's been sitting in a tomb for a bit. It's got some weathering on it, maybe. But not all of it. Some of it's going to look like really nice. Obviously, it's all going to have a little bit of speckling and metal shave damage and stuff like that. And I figured this was a really fun way to do this piece because it's, you know, it's an Egyptian thing. The whole Egyptian thing, they, you know, a lot of their architecture and statuettes and stuff, they loved gold. So I figured this would be a fun way to dress up this cat statue and make her nice and gold. And since this was one of my demonstrations for my seaming and finishing, I figured y'all might want to see kind of what she turned out with the full finished seam and stuff. Her stomach seams came out good. The leg and arm seams came out perfect. I have no, absolutely no complaints. But as you can see, she comes off camera so often, and you're really staring at her feet during this presentation quite a lot. So I didn't want you guys to have to watch this all. The whole process took me a little bit longer to do her because she's so large. I believe she's about a 25 centimeter piece, so she's pretty tall. But the end result you will get to see once we're done. So we'll be back in a sec. All right, and there's the finished pieces. You can see there we've got all the gold laid out, and you know, like I said, not perfect. I wanted parts of this to look like it was old, and you know, knocked around. Maybe someone, you know, tried to lift it and they dropped it on their way out or something. But regardless, I think the actual final look is fantastic on all the pieces that we tried this out on. This is such a cool application tool for model making and collectible stuff. Like I said, if you're not a great painter, this is a great way to finish your stuff. If you are a great painter, you're going to find a use for this in your arsenal of tools for sure. And it's a really cool metallic finish that you get on it. Like I said, you can even buff it when you're done to shine it up. And there's various ways you can do that. You can use the little tiny brush that I showed you with the little small head, and that's a way to do it. So there's a, and you can also do it with like a paper towel or cloth, will work as well. Anyway, here's all the final pieces that we tested out with these colors, and they look gorgeous. Really love the way they look, especially with the gold and the antique, or the gold leaf and the antique looking gold there. Look fantastic. Anyway, guys, I hope you all enjoyed this episode. This was fun for us to make, and we really appreciate you guys watching as well. We broke well over 500 subscribers last month, and we keep on climbing every single day. So we appreciate you guys watching. Let us know if you like episodes like this one. We'll continue to kind of do more hands-on stuff. And don't forget to hit that subscribe, like, and the bell notification so you get notifications about episodes we make. See you guys soon.